So in this tutorial we will be solving some loops which are growing exponentially. So in this loop, this part is telling us that this function, this I, is getting values exponentially. Okay, so in such cases, suppose because we understood this thing, right? Okay, let me add one thing. So here I is getting values from 1, for I equals to 1, this is running theta 1 time, for I equals to 2, this is equals to 2 to the power 0, for 2 it's 2 to the power 1, for 4 it's 2 to the power 2, for first time, this is for first time, this is second time, this is third time, okay, 2 to the power 3 for fourth time, this kind of relationship is there, okay. So now what is actually required? So for say 2 to the power, for some kth term, there will be 2 to the power k minus 1, right? The value of I. So we can extend this thing. So now we got this idea. This is the generalization which we made for this loop. So for kth iteration, value of I is 2 to the power k minus 1. Okay, so what is this? We can take, since this is the value of I, we can have, so the k is the iteration, right? K is here the iteration. So till what value will it go? Suppose that the loop ends, okay, let's make it more generic. Suppose that this is the upper limit, that for some last round, say this is some last round, and this last round, this value should be equals to, should be equals to n, right? They should be less than equals to n, but we are assuming that this value should be equals to n somewhere. So what we need to find here is that at some round, suppose after kth round, the value achieved is this, and this should be or less than equals to, this should be less than equals to n. So we can have the number of rounds here. For k, this is it, kth round, which is the last one, last round or the last iteration. So we can have this as 2 to the power k divided by 2 equals to n, or you can write it as n cross 2. Okay, so what this k can be taken as, I can ignore this constant or I can just take it, or that doesn't matter. This is 2n. Okay, so 2 to the power k is this, so k will be log of 2n to the base 2. I can write it here as k equals to log of 2n to the base 2, or you can just write it like this, because this is log a cross b, so we, which can be taken as log a plus log b. So this is log 2 to the base 2 plus log n to the base 2. This is constant, you know, so adding a constant value to some variable function is actually doesn't matter. That's again log n only. So you have k which is of equal to log n, and actually this is the order, so k equals to theta of log n. So you are getting the idea how to solve such exponentially increasing loops with the iterator variable which is increasing exponentially. So this is one way to solve it. Now we can have some more such we now know that how to solve such exponentially increasing iterator loops. Now we can include, we can merge two such loops which we studied in previous lecture and in this lecture. Okay, so he will be telling me how to solve this. For I equals to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. For j equals to 1, less than n, j equals to j cross 2, and some theta 1 operation here. So now we know that such function which we just saw, this is what? This is theta of log n. Okay, so this is theta of log n. So you can just replace this whole thing with this theta of log n. So for n such iteration, log n is being implemented. So what you will tell is that for this is being log n is being executed for n rounds. So this is theta of n log n. Okay, quite easy. Okay, now let's make it little more tough. Okay, this is a loop. Now there is another loop for j equals to 0, j less than I, j plus plus, and some theta 1 operation inside. Now what? We got this thing here. Earlier we had n here. Now this is, earlier n was the upper limit which was always checked if j is crossing that upper limit or not. But now here it's I. So how to solve this? Okay, so let's take it. So for I equals to 0, j is taking value from 0 to, for I equals to 0, j will be 0 because 0 to 0 is 0 only. So this will be running theta 1 time. For I equals to 1, for j will be taking value 0, theta 1, and for j equals to 1, it's again theta 1. Similarly, for I equals to 2, j will be taking 0, 1 and 2. So this will be 3 times theta of 1. So are you getting the idea that for I equals to say k, j will be going from 0, 1, 2 up to k, and that will be almost k into theta of 1, and this k is a variable. So what you got here? We have this thing is running for say kth round or the last round where I equals to n. So for I equals to n, j is taking value from 0, 1 up to n, and this will be n cross theta 1. But there are some previous values also, right? For I equals to n minus 1, same n minus 1 cross theta 1. So there is a series. This is n minus 2 cross theta n theta 1 and up to theta 1. So there is a series of such 1 cross theta 1, then 2 cross theta 1. So we need to sum these all. So how we sum it? The time complexity will be theta 1 plus 2 cross theta 1 plus 3 cross theta 1 plus up to n cross theta 1. So what is this? You can just take theta 1 out and you will be finding 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus up to n. And what is it? It's an AP, which is sum of n natural numbers, which is n n plus 1 by 2. Okay, and this is constant. So anyhow, this is being n square plus n by 2, which is again n square. Okay, so this will be the complexity. Okay, so now we studied little more complicated iterative constructs also. Can we make it little more complex just by doing this thing? Okay, let's leave it. Okay, let me shortly explain you about the third structure, that is recursive. Okay, so So how to solve such problems, complexity problems which are having recursive programming constructs in it. So summation of n numbers, n natural numbers. So this function can be easily solved with a loop, or this can be solved with some recursion. So recursion is actually, okay, first let me explain the recursion. What is recursion? When a function problem, if being solved in terms of its own but with smaller size, this is called recursion. So what is, how will you understand this? Let me tell you and through an example. So suppose you want to find the shortest path from A to B. Okay, that's a nice example. You understood this thing? No? Okay. We need to find a shortest path from A to B. And there are some nodes C, D, E, and F also. Now, the problem is that you need to find the shortest. There may be many edges between any nodes. Okay. Doesn't matter. Okay, so each is having some problems. Somewhere traffic is there, somewhere there are lots of congestion and all. Okay, so now what is the solution of this? So we can solve this problem. The guy here can say that I can get the shortest path from A to C, and then I will get, I have this path, I know this path which is the shortest between me and C, but the next path, the shortest path will be computed once I reach there. So what I'm telling is that the A to C, suppose the distance is A. So now the guy walked for A, and now the path problem P is path problem P1, which is actually path finding the shortest path from C to B. Okay, so call it from A to B. Now this is from C to B. Okay, now this can be again broken into A plus from C to B. Say D is the shortest, D is the closest node from this point. So I will be, the guy here will be telling that okay, I can go from till D with a distance C. So this will be added to this actual existing distance, and then find the shortest path from D to B. So you are getting the idea what is being done here. We are actually, to find this solution of this bigger problem, we are solving smaller problem. We here we solved this problem, the solution this problem is this. Now iteratively, not iteratively, in next round we will be solving this problem in its own definition. Okay, so it's like calling this function again but with smaller input. Now calling this function again, but instead of AB we'll be using DB as the shortest path problem but with smaller input. So this is how recursion goes on. And you might have coded some problems for Fibonacci, but okay, we'll discuss this programming construct in next tutorial.